coach's dream, wasn't it? Guys picked up all of their assignments, created a nice gap for the running back to get through, pick up 7 yards. Yeah, he's probably chortling on the headset right now saying, we got it going, boys. Let's keep it going.
On second down, they'll run with White. And he gets stopped up at the 31 after a gain of maybe a yard.
But not much on that one, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Mucked that down for a win in the defense's column.
On third and two, Moulton. And it is caught. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. First catch of the new season for him, and he picks up the first. That catch now puts him on the doorstep of 500. It's his 499th reception. A first red zone opportunity of the new year here as they come up now first and 10. White running to the left. Able to fight for about 4 yards there to the 13.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Second down and 6 now. Off the bootleg, Moulton, they'll roll him out right. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
And I think he's got to be careful as he continues to try to extend plays because he's already been intercepted in this game. And the coverage, they continue to challenge all his receivers downfield.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a 3rd and 6.
Now they'll change things up.
To throw on third down, Moulton. He completes it right side to White. And this won't do it. He needed 6. He only got halfway there.
Another completion there. You know, we think about the draft back in the spring. He was selected, obviously, the number 1 overall pick. There's great money with that, but Charles, I would think maybe an extra burden too, or is that not that big of a deal at all?
It actually is in the beginning of his career an added burden, but it's one of those things that if you play well, it becomes something that justifies why you were taken number 1. You're fine with that. If you don't play well, it can be an albatross.
Field goal unit and Brian Johnson out there. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. And Johnson's kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3.
So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number 1. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive.
And Charles, nothing like squaring off with a division opponent, a division rival in week 1. Do you like that they are matching up this early, or would you prefer a game like this be a few weeks down the road?
I actually like the early matchup for a few reasons, Brandon. First of all, it allows you to see that in the entire offseason and know, hey, right out of the gate, we're playing a division game. Second part is it spreads them out a little bit. If you just have them all bunched up at the end of the year, that's not as much fun watching teams try to survive that gauntlet when you do have injuries down the stretch. And last but not least, let's face it, we're TV people. What a great game to sell right out of the gate.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
3rd and 5.
Keep moving. Doesn't matter. They can't.
Touchdown.
pitch to his right.
Wow, that is incomplete.
Partner, we've got ourselves a ball game, and those guys on defense, they came to play. Slipped up on their first series, but they're definitely settling in now and letting it be known that points won't come so easy again.
On is the punter, Hecker, as he gets this one away. And take it right on the 30. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt, and the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
So from the 37, here's a 2nd and 9. Back to throw, Moulton. It's caught by Mike Evans. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. First catch there for Evans, good enough for a first down.
A nice completion there for the first down. And Charles, you think about the quarterbacks of recent vintage that have been thrust into action week one. It's no guarantee of future success, but we sure have seen some good ones.
We certainly have, partner. How about Joe Burrow with the Bengals in 2020? He was excellent. Kyler Murray with the Cardinals, the best part about his game, had his team right at the brink of the playoffs. And Deshaun Watson has won division titles after having started from day one.
A good pickup there, 22.
And that was good protection there. No, that was great protection there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver, although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice game.
Down to about the 22 here. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3. After 1, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. 2nd quarter now, and it's Buccaneer football as they've got it with a 2nd and 3 forthcoming. Another completion there, and what a big moment in a young quarterback's life, that first NFL start. And Charles, obviously they want him to win games, but if they're looking at him under a microscope in this first month or so, what do you think they're hoping to see from him?
Well, for every question they'll have for him, they should have for themselves as a coaching staff, because it's not just how quickly can he learn the offense, it's what they can teach him, right? How can he build a relationship with his receivers? And of course, how open is he to learning? And of course, how open are they to giving him things that he can put in place on the field?
A misconnection there. He's hit on just 50% of his passes thus far. That's not where you want to be.
Now you see the evolution of the game. You go back to the quarterbacks of old, 50% would be terrific because they threw the ball downfield almost every time they threw it. Now with the short passing game, you should be above 60% just to be in the average range.
And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Rashad White, 14 yards, and the Bucs have taken the lead.
You get in a 2nd and long situation down here in the red zone, I I'd say most defensive coaches would think pass. Let's bring some pressure. So this is kind of a tendency breaker here to hit him with something on the ground, and he'll take it all the way into the end zone.
And Johnson's extra point up and good, and the lead is now 10-7. The Bucs ready for the kickoff, and here we go. It's in the air, and that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And Charles, a very uninspired effort. The last time we saw them out there was a quick three and out when they punted the football.
Yeah, you never want to get stopped so soundly during a series, but what would be even worse now is letting it happen again right here. They've got to get going.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here, and what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Another run with Sanders. Yeah, he'll fight for a couple as the tackle is made at about the 32. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Here's third and three. Young to throw it. Pass taken in. He's going to be taken down. Plus, there's a penalty flag in the backfield. They may get 15 more on top of this. Charles, did I just hear that right? They declined the personal foul. 3 yards, they just declined them.
And I have to think that the official is thinking to himself, did I just hear that correctly, that you declined that one? All I can think of is that someone on the field got confused.
Must have.
It had to, because you're going to take the yards on that penalty each and every time.
Eluding the pressure right. Got his man, it's Jonathan Mingo. Now the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
I know we just saw a nice throwing catch, but how about the big guys up front buying that time? Yeah, that's exactly what they did. They created time and allowed the space to happen, and it turned into a really nice play.
On play action, Young. He's got goal. He's got room at the 30. He'll head out of bounds inside the 10, marking down at the 9. A big play that time on the catch and run, 39 yards.
You get a rookie tight end who can run like this, it just gives this offense a different dimension than they've had. It's going to be fun to watch his development and how this offense expands as this season moves along.
The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. They'll run with Sanders, and he stopped immediately there. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Another shot from the 9 on second and goal. Once again with Sanders. And he will take it across for Panthers touchdown. Miles Sanders, already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Panthers have retaken the lead.
Sometimes you get a first and goal and you're back near the 7, 8, 9 yard line and you start thinking, maybe we'll run it here on first down to get half of what we need, so maybe we can have 2 or 3 shots at going for it from closer range. So this is a bonus right here. What a great run to work his way into the end zone.
Pinheiro's extra point up and good. And the lead is now 14-10. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that. In Charles's defense, they were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 47. They go with White on the counter. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
So if you've been playing defense in this one, there's a little bit of the good and some bad, because they did give up the touchdown run to him earlier but shut him down otherwise.
Outside of that, you're exactly right. I would say they've contained him very well. From the 46, here's the second down and 9. From the gun, Moulton. That's complete to his receiver, Gavin. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 30. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. And he has now hit number 500. Charles, that is his 500th NFL career catch.
Definitely worthy of applause, but I remember when 500 meant you were going to the Hall of Fame. Nowadays, in today's football, 500 puts you on the path, a significant number.
Throwing on first down, Moulton. Throwing left sideline there, but it's incomplete.
And their back's up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple of more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
Now a second and 10. To throw again, Moulton. And this one incomplete. Too much contact on that one, and it's third down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
To throw again. He's got his target. That's complete. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the 1. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
I think he has to be saying to himself, how did that not wind up a touchdown? Remember, you just need the tip of the ball to cross the plane. It's not going to get there, but they're going to be set up in great shape with first and goal.
They go play action here on first down. And this is caught. For the moment, it's a touchdown, but multiple flags down, so let's sort this out. Another shot from the 1 on second and goal. The play fake. Moulton toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
That's a pretty play there. Got in at the last second, helped force the ball free and kept them out of the end zone. Three, eight.
think about it right now in this season opener. It's third and goal. Off play action. Moulton. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Co-keefed from a yard out. And the Buccaneers have moved out in front.
This is where, as a tight end, you've got to really sell that this is a run. They're going to fake the give, hope the linebackers bite, and here they do just enough. That split second, that's all it takes for that tight end to leak out into the end zone. Touchdown.
And Johnson's extra point up and good, and it's now 17-14. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. A long drive last time out for this offense, Charles. If you remember, they started basically in the shadows of their own end zone, marched it down the field, and a lot of that was through the passing game.
And partner, as a former defensive back, I'm having almost a physical reaction watching what's happening right now. But let's give credit where it's due, because they've done an excellent job moving the ball through the air. Secondary getting picked apart pass by pass. Obviously, they need to make some adjustments there on the back end.
And because offensively, we know that they're not going to be shy about throwing that football. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. They'll come up facing third and five. Young. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man. And he's going to have the Panthers first down. They needed five there on third down. He winds up getting seven. Young now. That's over the middle and caught by Mingo. So just 3 yards on the completion there. And it's second down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
Second and seven.
Let's end this drive with six.
From the shotgun, it's Young.
Nice throw.
And he slings one that's incomplete. Just his second incompletion so far. He's 8 for 10. I think he'll take 80%.
There's no doubt that he will, but if you're the defensive play caller, you better circle what you just dialed up on your play sheet and come back to it, because you just caused an incompletion. You need a few more of those.
They head to the line facing a third and seven following the incompletion on second down. It'll be Young again. And we'll find the open man. That's complete. And he is brought down, but not before reaching the field. That's a gain of 31 with right around 1 minute to go in the quarter.
We'll find out how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they took field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So the big play has him all the way down to the 30 now for first and 10. Sanders here as they run out of the gun. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
So from the 22, here's second and two. Now here's Young. Escaping the pressure right. And that one will fall incomplete. Clock here now just under 30 seconds to go in this first half.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move,
Defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of him, and I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
Young on third and two. Flushed out right. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth.
They converted twice on third down that drive already, but couldn't make it a third. We always talk about in-game adjustments. How about what the defense did there, able to shut them down on that attempt?
This is up and good from Pignero. And that will tie things at 17-all. Maybe a nice psychological boost there just to get back to even with that field goal as we head towards half.
Coaching 101 always says at halftime, play it like it's 0-0 on the scoreboard. Well, in this case, it's level, right? Same score each side. Just start over. Now you get the second half to play.
And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
I tell you what, that's a veteran play from a guy in his first season in the NFL. A lot of rookies are trying to force something there. He thought better of it, and that was the right decision.
Second and 10. Not wanting to take a chance this time, they'll keep it on the ground. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout. If they hurry, we'll see.
The second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Here is third and 5. Operating from the gun, Moulton. And he backs it away. Falls down incomplete.
And they're not going to go quietly into this halftime break. They know they're in for a fight, so they're trying to make every possession count. They took the big shot there, but it winds up incomplete.
And likely time for one final play here in the half, so they will go for it on fourth down. A final shot before break. Moulton. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number 3. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. This offense ready for the first drive of the third quarter. Well, quarters number 1 and 2, entertaining. We saw some good offense points put up, Charles, and all tied on the scoreboard.
And it sets us up for what could be a really fun second half because we've seen both sides score first and one in the first half. And now, here in the second half, getting the ball first, you've got to think, hey, we can go out and really roll offense what we did in the first half. If I'm a defensive player, is, can I make a play to really help out my team and break this streak of offense?
On first and 10, it's Sanders. And he edges forward, but only gets a pair of yards out of it. And it's second down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front. Because if they can't get upfield, Their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find the hole.
And good vision there as he's across midfield and down to the 45-yard line. 40 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
Seemed like a couple sets of eyes were on the quarterback, so he decided, hey, I'm going to hand this off. Got a good gain out of it.
And you know you need good blocking up front in order to gain yardage, but every one of these RPOs, if you do it right and they look the same, whether it's handed off inside or the quarterback keeps it, that allows you to fool the defense so often. And in this case, fooled him with the inside run.
The result, only 4 yards there on the play, and that'll make it second down. An option handoff given to Sanders. Oh, that one well designed as he'll take this down to the 30-yard line. 11 yards and a Panther first down.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. He's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
On first and 10, Young. And this one into the hands of DJ Shark. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And it'll bring up a second and short.
Right, offense, keep pushing the ball downfield.
Up the middle they go with Sanders. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup, and that's all they needed to move the sticks.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I've been the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs, and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
From the red zone now, Young. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Yes, sir. How about an attaboy there on first down? Got his hand in and knocked it away.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Young off the play fake. That one complete. He finds Sharp. That'll leave him with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. Third down, they'll run with Sanders. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. He finds his way into the secondary again on this drive. They might want to try and get him down a little closer to the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, what do they call that? 3rd level run, 1st level being the D-line, and linebacker 2nd level in the secondary, the 3rd. When you block it up well and you make the secondary do all the tackling, that will wear on a defense.
Young will set to throw. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. Adam Thielen, a 1-yard touchdown reception. And the Panthers have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the 2nd half. Well, Charles, he's still a young signal caller in this league, 2nd year in the NFL. But I don't know if last year as a rookie, if he would have worked through his progressions like he did on that touchdown pass.
I think you're right about that. We're seeing him grow up right in front of our eyes because when he went to his primary read, he recognized that they were all over that. So he continued to survey the field, picked up another target, delivered a pass exactly where it needed to be. A very mature play for the 2nd-year quarterback.
And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. A solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And they'll be working from behind now following the touchdown a moment ago on the opening drive of the half.
I think the guys right now as they go out on offense, they're zeroing in on one big key. They don't have to do anything differently just because they're down on the scoreboard now. The intent, still the same in what they plan to do on offense.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Looking to throw, Moulton. Looking downfield for Godwin. And that's caught inside the 30. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Chris Godwin, 71 yards. And the Bucs strike quickly here to tie up the ball game. He put quite a bit of air underneath that touchdown pass. Of course, we knew that he had the strong arm.
That part was easy. You could see that throughout his college career. But what you want to know about a rookie is, when the pressure's on, can you throw with touch? He just did right there. And boy, it was pretty.
And it's no good. He missed it. And the game remains tied. Oh, boy. Nothing separating these two teams on the scoreboard as the kick's away here. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. That last drive, it was a good mix. Run, pass, run, pass. Defense on their toes.
And what really helps out in a big way is when you're doing the run, pass, mix, and everything's working, that means that they're guessing wrong every time on defense. They think you're going to pass when you run, and vice versa. I would continue that, and when they finally draw a bead on you, maybe you mix it up a little bit, a little play action, and throw the ball.
And will they maintain that balance? Time to find out. Flush to his right. That is caught by Thielen, and he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Give him 18, it's a Carolina first down.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them, and these guys have been taking advantage so far.
Shotgun snap, and then the give to Sanders. And a good run here as he'll rumble all the way down to the 40-yard line. 80 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
Partner, we always talk about how important third down is, but I think first down is equally important because everything comes off of that play. If the defense wins the down, they are able to attack. If the offense wins the down, they might go faster, do other things, and change things up. That big play right there allows this offense to really get in gear.
First down, Young. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. And so close, he gets it to the run. Out of bounds right there. They give him a gain of 38.
This play is a thing of beauty when it works as designed because they let the running back slip out of the backfield and head down the sideline on a wheel route. Number one, it's easy for him to get lost. And number two, really tough for the linebacker to run with him. And this ball's right on the money and leads to a big play.
Eluding the pressure right. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Bryce Young with now 3 week 1 touchdowns. And the Panthers have broken our tie as they take the lead.
That's a really good decision right there outside of the pocket. You've got to know the right time to shift from passer to runner. He was looking and looking, nothing there. You can almost feel the brainwaves firing as he calculates. I think I can win a race to the pylon. And he turns out to be right. Touchdown.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And this is going to be returned from middle of the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards.
The Bucks offense set to begin their next possession. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
Man, confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They're giving him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And incomplete on the deep ball.
And that one's all about timing. If he's here too early, it's going to be a pass interference call. If he's too late, it's a completed pass. He was Johnny on the spot.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. The play fake. Moulton on the move to his left. And that will be incomplete.
That's some applause from the defense there. They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
Here comes the Buccaneers punter now, as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. Fielded just inside the 30. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. A good return there, 17 yards. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush, pass rush, pass rush. Whether it's the guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the ball.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here. Now he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down.
I'll tell you what, this defense hasn't played its best, but they're still right in this football game. And if they keep making plays just like that, they're going to give their offense a chance.
And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. We are through three quarters here on NFL Kickoff Weekend. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Just week one, but already plenty of intrigue with the games going on, and this one no different as we come up on a first and 10. They'll try to throw now. Young rolling to his right. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down.
I did like his decision-making there to make sure they picked up something instead of forcing a throw. Now they've got more manageable play coming up to try and pick up the first down. And don't rule out the possibility that he just keeps it and runs again.
Second down and 3. Running right, here's Sanders. They got two of the three they needed there. Leaves them with third and just a yard.
If they're going to get a first down out of this, they're going to have to earn it, because there's been tough going in the interior there. And here we are on 3rd and 1. Be prepared. Brace yourself. Could be some contact going on.
The Panthers on 3rd down. They've been very good. 5 for 7 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. Meanwhile, the throw by Young was knocked away and incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. And here's a big one now. Trying to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on 4th down. Going for it with Sanders. And this winds up a disaster. Nowhere near the marker. And the Panthers turned away on 4th down. And the Buccaneers defense holds and they get the football back. The Buccaneers in good field position here to start out 1st and 10 at the 39-yard line. They begin the drive on the ground. It's White. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. 5 yards is the tally on 1st down. That brings up 2nd and 5.
Oh, that was a thing of beauty right there. Look at how quick those blockers fired off the line once the ball was snapped. That was an O-line on a mission, all in sync, and the defense is lucky that play only picked up 5 yards.
And he'll get it down to the 47 here. 50 yards rushing for him now as he's carried it 13 times.
And that's a nice pickup of a 1st down on that 2nd down run. And if that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
Now a play fake here on 1st down. He'll buy some time right. Just get rid of it.
At this point in the second half, one mistake on a forced throw could doom your chances of a comeback, so that's the right call there to just throw that one away.
Here's 2nd and 10. They defer to White out of the shotgun. And good space to operate there as he takes this down inside the 35-yard line. 14 yards there and a Buccaneer 1st down. Off play action. Moulton sliding out of the pocket. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Well, they've been back on their heels a little bit here on this drive, but a chance to exhale just a little bit there with incompletion on 1st down. Now they have to gear up, try and get 2 more stops and escape this drive.
After the incomplete pass here now is 2nd and 10. In motion goes the tight end. And 2nd and 10, he'll look to throw again. Escaping the pressure right. And that, what a dangerous throw there back across the field. But it's incomplete.
I thought at first he tried to run, but he just kept blocking time to his right. Nothing there. He also gets rid of it.
Here comes the 7th play now of this drive as this is 3rd and 10. Operating from the gun, Moulton. Oh, he rifles one and that's going to be intercepted. And Xavier Woods with a pick. And the Panthers are going to take over once again at their own 25-yard line. 3rd and long that time. He was trying to make something happen, but a little too risky.
Well, the field tilted on him, and what I mean by that is what you said. 3rd and long, got to push it downfield to try and pick up the 1st down. Defensive backs live for this situation, and they took advantage of the young man right there.
It'll be Sanders to begin the drive. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right at a yard.
Well, partner, Marvin, 97 yards on the ground today. You think he's going to get the ball again?
I think so. Three away from that century mark, got to have it.
Yeah, and I think what they're going to call is one of his favorite runs, whatever he feels comfortable with, and what the offensive line has executed well today to try and get him over 100 yards.
And he gets us to the other side of midfield, across the 35 before going out. A gain there of 21 yards.
When you have success throwing the football, the old cliche becomes true. The playbook opens up wide, and these screen passes, they become even more difficult to stop.
And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
And Young's throw there incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now Young. Flushed out right. And that's incomplete.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. And that hits at the six and carries into the end zone for a touchback. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started.
So now, Charles, this drive, maybe a touch more important, trying to erase the memory of that interception they had the last time out.
And everyone goes through this because even the best of the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go right for you and interceptions result. So, frankly, to me, it's all about how you respond, not just the types of plays that you call, but how you carry yourself, how you show your team that you're still with it, and how you continue to lead.
Looking to throw on second down. Moulton. It's caught. This is White. And he'll be corralled right around the 34. That's good for a Buccaneer first, a pickup of 12 yards. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Play fake. Moulton. And there's a short one taken in by Otten. So a nice throw there. And CD, I have to think you've been impressed with what you've seen thus far here in his debut.
Now, you know me well. I've been impressed because what I've seen is him starting to understand how to play the game in a short amount of time. The dazzling plays, they'll come with experience. But right now, we're seeing him handle the game, make all the smart plays and the right reads.
Motion man is Schwartz. To throw on second down, Moulton. That is caught. It's Chris Godwin. Now he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30.
Running their plays over and over during the week and often get robotic for an offense. But on game day, they can often flow smoothly, as that one just did.
Plenty of time. All three timeouts still remain. Here's first and 10 now. They'll look to throw. And in for the Buccaneers touchdown. Russell Gage, 32 yards. And the Bucs are an extra point away from tying this game here in the final minutes. And what a throw that was, Charles. You think about the situation, close game, fourth quarter, rookie quarterback. He doesn't seem fazed one bit.
So much for bright lights, big city, and will he wilt? Not at all. The stage not too big, the moment not too big at all. They needed points on that series, and not only did he produce a touchdown drive, but how about finishing it off with a big play that only adds to the momentum that they've already established.
What a start to the season this has been. Back and forth, all tied fourth quarter as the kick is away here.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25.
Here's first and 10.
They start on the ground here at Sanders. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being that's a good first step and several steps to go.
They still have time for the possible game-winning field goal. Time for them to be quick and at the same time.
Here's first down.
Sanders, and he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
It went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Well, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
Here's a second and 7. Young. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down.
Now we're in the situation where the quarterback's got to take full charge of his huddle, got to totally command and make sure all eyes are on him, all focus is locked in. Going to call multiple plays and go over different situations and scenarios to make sure everyone is on the same page.
Here's Young.
Flush to his right. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Carl Lawson with a little how do you do as he gets in there for the sack. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 20.